everyone. Hope you're having a great day. Wanted to hop on and talk about how, you know, it's ultimately not about your opinion or my opinion, but what's important and most important is what his opinion is in our personal lives. You know, I think that our nation has kind of been in a tumultuous time over the last couple years. Specifically for my American friends. I'm sure you guys in other countries have kind of been watching on the sidelines as well. But it's just been a tough couple years with 2020, 2021 in terms of, you know, world events that have been going on. And, you know, a lot of Christians are confused. A lot of Christians are not kind of knowing where to stand and what to do. And so I'm kind of hopping on here to give you the God perspective, not to talk about sides, not to talk about all of that, but to give you perspective in terms of, as a Christian, how do we align ourselves? Now, I'm not talking to non-Christians today. I wish they would line up with biblical values, but as a Christian, your life no longer belongs to you. Amen. When you surrender your life to Jesus, you make him the Lord of your life. And so our job as a Christian is to line up with what he says. You know, our opinion ultimately is just that. It's our opinion, but in the long run, it's not what counts. His opinion is what counts, ladies and gents. You know, the whole book of Ecclesiastes in the Bible, it talks about, you know, like, this is meaningless. This means nothing under the sun. And he goes through all of these different statements. And ultimately, it all goes back to all of this stuff that we're going through right now is going to pass away. But what ultimately matters is aligning with God. What ultimately matters is what he says in our personal lives and over our circumstances. And so I think it's very important to say, as a Christian, that ultimately, if our opinion is different from the God opinion, we're the ones who are wrong. And this is what it is when it comes to politics. And what I see so much, and it's such a spirit of pride, it's such a Leviathan kind of thing that is going on in our society right now. Everybody has an opinion on everything, right? And it's your opinion versus my opinion, and we're very vocal and we're very loud about those opinions. But ultimately, you guys, if you're a Christian, it's not about what your opinion is. We're called to be in alignment with what his opinion is. And so you might look at me and you might ask me, well, Jill, how am I supposed to know what God's opinion is? Well, you've got to be in your Bible on a daily basis. And you've got to be in the prayer closet over our nation on a regular basis in order to correctly discern and interpret what's going on right now. Listen, ladies and gents, the news media presents a story to you, and they present what they want you to see on both sides of the aisle. Some sides are worse than others. I'm going to say that and put it out there. But they present what they want you to see. And so it takes a Christian diving into the prayer closet and being in their Bible on a regular basis to really discern what's going on and what God wants us praying for and how God wants us to be in alignment in this season. And so pride will cause a quote-unquote Christian to align with what they think feels good rather than what the Bible says and what God is calling us to. And I want to talk to you guys about how dangerous that is. You know, I had someone who was, you know, spouting off their opinions to me recently, and I didn't mean this in an ugly way, but I stopped him and I said, are you in your Bible on a daily basis? And they were like, well, no, I mean, I'm a Christian though. And I was like, when's the last time you prayed for our nation? And they were like, well, I mean, I think about it a lot. And I was like, sorry, nothing that you say to me is going to really take root. And I didn't mean that in an ugly way, but I told him, I was like, in order to correctly interpret what is going on right now, you have got to be in the Word. You have got to be praying, because you know what? Ultimately, I don't care what my perspective is, because my track record, apart from God, y'all, is not very good. And I think I could speak for the rest of human race. You know, our track record, apart from God's heart, is not good. We don't understand things. We can't get context. We have zero discernment apart from God's heart. So when you're listening to the news 24/7, you are hearing a repeat of people's opinions over and over and over again. But ultimately, people's track record, you guys, is not good. I'm not saying don't be informed. I'm not saying don't understand what the big issues are. But what I am saying is, what opinion are you listening to more in this season? Are you listening to that loud phone, that megaphone of different people's opinions? Or are you listening to God's opinion more? Are you in your prayer closet? Are you in your Bible? Are you asking God, how do you feel about this big hit issue? you know, that's going on in our society. What do you think about this, Lord? And God, if I'm wrong, God, I pray that you would humble me and correct me to be in alignment with your will and what you say over these things, Father God. And so I also want to tell you guys today that the loudest and the most passionate voice is not always the correct voice. And I have seen this on both sides before, although we're seeing it a lot more with particular things right now. But, you know, the loudest voice, you guys, is not always the correct voice. If you think back to like high school or something, you know, you always had that super loud, super dominant person in the group, and whatever they said, a lot of the flock went with. Well, just because it's loud and passionate doesn't always mean it's correct, you guys. And so our job is to align ourselves with what God says as a Christian. Because again, it's not about our opinion anymore. If you have made him the Lord of your life, that means that he is your covering now, that we submit to him and to his, you know, judgment and to his covering over our lives. And our opinion ultimately isn't what matters. Yes, I believe that we need to have a voice. Yes, I believe that we need to stand for truth and stand out for truth. But ultimately, you guys, you cannot discern what's going on unless you are in the Word. Because remember, I did a video on this a while back. The Bible is the only book in the world that when you are reading it, it is reading you. We need grounding in this season, you guys, of something reading those motives, those thoughts, those intentions of our heart. Because what the devil does is he clouds it. And when we're away from our Bible for a long period of time, we have all these different opinions and we're taking in all this information, some of which is correct and some of which is not correct. And we need something examining our hearts to tell us whether or not we're off track. You know, I've given you guys the example of the anchor before. If you're floating on top of a lake or something and you're not anchored, your vessel, your float, before you know it, is going to end up on the other side of the lake, and it does it gradually. You don't notice it all at once a lot of the time, but before you know it, you're way off from where you started. That's what it looks like, you guys, with the current situation. One day not anchored can put you way off into la-la land, you guys. And so all of that to say, what I want to tell you guys is, as a Christian, you and I can have an opinion, but ultimately it means nothing. What does mean something is if we are in alignment with his opinion. And so as a Christian, it's no longer, oh, my opinion is this because I want it to be this way. Our job is to be in alignment with God. And the only way that we're going to be able to discern whether or not we are in alignment with God's opinion and to find out what his opinion is regular time spent in our prayer closet, praying over our nation, listening to wise leaders who have come through hard times and who are really locked into God. You know, let me hit on that a little bit because we haven't talked about that. In this season, I am doing a lot more of listening to elders in the church, to people in leadership who have seen our nation go through hard times and who have a really, really good track record. And, you know, again, just because it's the loudest and most passionate voice does not necessarily mean that it's the correct voice. And so I think it's important for us to listen to the wisdom of our elders who have been there, done that in this season, and to not just listen to any elders, but to listen to people who are truly locked in with God, who are truly praying over this nation, who are really seeking God and his will first and foremost above their own will. Those are the voices. If you're going to listen to voices in this season, you guys, those are the voices that are going to be more trustworthy. Ultimately, God's opinion trumps all of our opinions, you guys, which is why it's so important for you to have your own personal walk with God to find out what's going on. But those voices are the voices that are more trustworthy to be listening to in this season. And so it's important to have your own God time. It's important that you're listening to credible voices. And I want to tell you guys, you cannot interpret what's going on right now with all of this apart from having your own personal time with God and your own personal time at the prayer closet. Because again, just like in Ecclesiastes, man's opinions might be good intent, but they're meaningless. And as a Christian, if you claim to be a Christian, your opinion no longer matters. It's all about his opinion, and it is our job to stay in alignment with what God says. Amen. Hope you guys have a great day. I'll talk to you soon.